Good morning students, let's begin our science class. So today I am going to explain the new chapter, that is lesson number 15, and the heading of the chapter is some natural phenomena. In this chapter we will study about the structure of the atom as well as about the various natural phenomena like lightning and earthquake. In today's class I will explain the topic structure of atom. Students, if you remember that all the substances or materials, they are made up of matter. So it is important here for you to know how you will define the term matter. So anything which occupies space and has weight is called matter. And all the matter, they are made up of atoms. So in this way we can say that all the substances, they are made up of atoms, and these atoms, they consist of three fundamental particles, that is the protons, neutrons and electrons. The protons, they are positively charged, neutrons, they are having no charge, and the electrons, they are negatively charged particles of the atom. In the center of the atom, nucleus is present, and this nucleus consists of two fundamental particles, that is the protons and the neutrons, whereas the electron, which is the negatively charged fundamental particle of an atom, they revolve around the nucleus in the same manner as the planets revolve around the sun in the solar system. Besides this, students, you should also know that the positive charge in the atom is concentrated in the center and the negative charge is present surrounding the nucleus. Next to this, it is important that when you can say that the atom is electrically neutral, we can say that the atom is electrically neutral when it contains equal number of protons and neutrons. Similarly, the atom can be said to have positive charge if it contains more number of protons than the neutrons. And third condition is there, that is, they can be said to be negatively charged if they contain more number of neutrons rather than protons, then they can be said to be electrically negative. So this is about the structure of the atom. Beside this, you should also draw the label diagram which is given on page number 182 of your science book, that is figure number 15.1, and this figure you will draw in your CW and HW copy. And this is the homework of today's class. Now the next topic about which I will explain, that is the charged bodies. So here you should understand how the charges are produced on the various objects. So the material that has equal number of electrons and protons, they are said to be electrically neutral. And the protons and neutrons, they are very closely held in the central part of the atom, that is the nucleus. And it is difficult, very difficult to move them out. Then in the outermost, in the surrounding or the outermost, electrons are present, and these electrons, they can be easily transferred from one object to the other, another. Now question arises, how the charged bodies, they become positively charged or they become negatively charged. So the objects, they become positively charged when they lose the electrons. It means the number of the protons is more and the number of electrons, they become less in number, then the object becomes positively charged as a result of losing of the electrons. Whereas the object can be negatively charged, and the objects, they can be negatively charged when they gain the electrons. And in this case, what is there? That is, the number of the electrons are more than the number of the protons. So this is how the object can be decided that they are positively charged or they are negatively charged. Positively charged ions, positively charged objects, they are having more number of protons as compared to the number of electrons, whereas the negatively charged objects, they are having more number of electrons and less number of protons, and they become negatively charged by gaining the electrons. And this process of and the process of transfer of electrons can be caused by rubbing of the two materials together. So how this transfer of electrons can take place? This transfer of electrons can take place by rubbing of the two materials together. And this type of charging by rubbing of the object is called as charging by friction. So this is all about the structure of the atom as well as how the objects, they are positively or negatively charged. Now your homework for today is that you have to draw the Leyden diagram, that is figure number 15.1, which is given on page number 182 of lesson 15 in your CW and HW copy. Thank you and have a nice day.